We are beginning with continuing coverage of the Basin Complex wildfire and a new round of evacuations. Here is the latest information from the U.S. Forest Service. The fire grew 12,000 acres over the weekend to a total of 119,000 acres, with containment at 61%. Authorities issued a new mandatory evacuation effective tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock. It affects people living on Carmel Valley Road from Martin Road to Piney Creek Road. It also includes all of Martin Road. Carmel Valley Road will also be closed between those points. Now, the Martin Road under this order is south of Tassajara. It is not the Martin Road near Rancho Cañada. This is in addition to the mandatory evacuation that remains in effect for the lower Kashawa area and all of Tassajara. Upper Kashawa from Trampa Canyon to Carmel Valley Road is under a voluntary evacuation order tonight. Should be noted, though, that Highway 1 and Big Sur are wide open with no restrictions and no advisories. Now, if you'd like to see a detailed map, there is one set up for you at the Carmel Valley Community Center on Ford Road, or you can call the Forest Service at 796-1990. Carmel Valley Village is coming out in full force to show their appreciation for the firefighters. They're acknowledging the long hours that they've been putting in to try and protect their town. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen is live near Carmel Valley with the story.
Aaron, the talk of Carmel Valley Village is firefighters and their hard work. There are signs up all over thanking them, and that's not where the gratitude stops. As firefighters work to save Carmel Valley Village,
there is, of course, a contingency line behind that, so there are two strong lines between the fire and the village.
Local residents and businesses work to make their appreciation known.
The community is a beautiful community here. We gather together and we help each other out during hard times.
Carmel Valley Business Service has become a drop-off point for people to bring baked goods and treats for firefighters. June Plumley accepts the goodies.
We're just here to help.
Pages of donations show the community's outpouring in the last several days.
Brownies, and then during the very hot days, it's become evident that the firefighters need something salty.
Business owners like Deborah Wenzler of the Baum & Bloom Bakery have pitched in, too.
We're just so grateful for what they're doing, and everybody wants to do something. You know, you just feel like, gosh, what can I do and not get in the way?
Joanne Friday not only left behind snacks, but offered her specialty.
If they want a buzz cut or a cut, you know, I can do that complimentary for them.
Other business owners say after visiting with firefighters in the village, they more than deserve some special treatment.
They want to buy things for their families and their wives, and, you know, I talked to them a little bit about how long they've been away from their families, and some of them 13 days, you know, or even longer, and so I can't imagine what that's like.
Fire officials say the extra attention from Carmel Valley Village has not gone unnoticed.
The village is just being tremendous in the way they're turning out, the way they're making us feel welcome. It's a constant parade of people dropping off baked goods at the front gate.
Volunteers make two trips daily to the spike camp to drop off baked goods and other items. Now, one in the morning around 10:30, and then another one around 5 or 6 in the evening just before dinner to make sure all the firefighters get their fair share of some baked goods. Erin.
All right, Brittany. Thank you.